Dirty Dowdy Podcast is for an adult audience. The Dirty Dowdy Podcast may contain material that may be unsuitable for sensitive ears. Listener discretion is advised.
Hey everybody, what's up? It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast here on Longbox.FM, coming to you again another week, another strong week show we got planned for you. And as always, you guys can hit us up on multiple avenues. Find me on Twitter, Dirty Dowdy, or Longbox, Facebook pages, Dirty Dowdy Podcast, Longbox, and you can also call in. We got the phone ready, so 492-0450, that's up on our Ustream page. If you're checking us out on our website, the page is right there to the side. Click the little video screen, it'll pop up, and it'll get all the information. And all the technical shit is now done, and we can move on with the show.
I'm not going to do any of that.
You never do any of that.
Do shit.
Well, this show, this week, again, sponsored, brought to us by our favorite guys, people who bring beer, Riley's Brewing.
Woo.
Got something special coming up. Alex, what you got on that?
This Friday, August 7th, the Riley's / San Joaquin Worthogs collaboration beer release. It is an IPA. It's pretty tasty. It's one they brewed back in July. San Joaquin Warhogs is one of the longest-lasting homebrew clubs. And actually, they're based here out of Fresno, so they do some really good stuff. And this Friday at 5 p.m. at Das Bierhaus. If you're not sure where that's at, you can check it out on their Facebook page. I'm going to share it right now, too.
Sweet. That'll be up there on the pages. Also, you guys, if you want to participate in tonight with the Twitter hashes and tags and things and stuffs, DDP Podcast. That's going to be the one from now on. So you want to give us your thoughts or whatever, it'll pop up on the screen. Now, last week, we learned.
Now, it's time to showcase Soothing. What we have learned in the last week.
Oh. Kevin, now I always shut you out on this, and you always complain and bitch about it.
Yeah.
So the floor is yours.
Well, within the last week, today actually, I learned that my shits last exactly as long as my newly updated Facebook wall does.
What?
As long as it takes me to get to the most, through the most current, back to where, you know, it updated from, I've conditioned myself to shit for exactly that long.
Really?
As soon as I'm done, I'm like, oh, I'm finished.
I was just going to say the amount of posts you put or the amount of shits you take. So you can actually track your poo.
Ooh.
This is something to do now. Someone here is going to have to take this.
Track
your poo by Facebook posts.
I think your posts are just shit.
Oh, Chicago Dog. What you got?
I learned that there's a correct way to hang a roll of paper towels.
Yes, there is. Yes, yes, there is.
I wonder if some anal squeaky little hyper contract roommate of yours.
I don't have one of those.
Someone who doesn't speak much on the show?
I have two of those, actually.
He had a chart, didn't he? He brought out a graph and stuff.
No, I threatened him.
He told me I was moving out.
PowerPoint presentation.
Yeah. That was the deal breaker. I came out at night and I went, nope, no. Paper towels do not go on backwards.
You know when toilet paper was patented, it was designed to go over the top.
Mm-hmm.
And that was in the patent. Specified in the patent.
I like to reach behind and kind of get a nice feel.
Diddle around the back.
Yeah. Check the oil.
That's definitely a Chicago dog thing.
That's like those people that get pissed off at the bread containers, the little twisty ties that go on the bread, and you just get all pissed off because people are taking them off and throwing them and spinning the loaf and then putting it underneath.
Well, I only do that because I'm not insane.
Yeah. Yeah. I get pissed off at people like that.
Well, speaking of pissed off, I did learn something last week while listening to the show and editing. Apparently, Molestar Kevin has a temper. He's not a fan of people talking over him, as these clips will show.
Do I get a montage?
What are you saying?
Investigators discovered the man had been posing as an officer,
Middle Eastern,
for at least 2 years. You got to slow down there, Chief. The groundskeeper of a golf course, frustrated that the bus driver was trying to charge him extra for another stop, a man took his rage out on the vehicle.
It's a quarter.
He's white. Asian.
The vehicle
black.
Won.
Definitely black.
Shut up.
So, yeah. Notice you just kept getting worse and worse.
I feel so honored.
So lesson for everybody in the room, don't talk over Molestar here. He gets mad.
I will.
I wasn't intending for that lesson to get out at all.
Well, I'll tell you what, guys, we're getting fancy tonight. We have a special guest in tonight. They're doing an event tomorrow. We'll be talking to them here off the break. It's the C.a.K.e. Art Hop. We got Claudio in here to talk and to fancy it up, and we'll put the pictures on our Facebook and also check out on Periscope here during the break. Jenny, lovely Jenny, brought us a wonderful supply of cheese and crackers.
I spared no expense. Top-notch cheese, crackers, and wine.
I think it was actually no expense. We got, what is it, saltine individually wrapped cheese pieces of American or not even...
It's Monterey Jack.
Somehow I'm thinking okay. It's boxed wine and bottled cheese.
Yeah.
I put out cheese spread from Walmart.
Bring out the whiz.
Well, we're gonna break out the fancy food and some more of this Riley's Brewing, the Sancha and the India IPA, and hit us up on on Periscope here during the break and check out what's going on. We're gonna chat real quick on the side with Claudio, and when we come back, we're gonna be discussing Art Hop.
You're listening
tomorrow night
to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm.
Oops.
Listen and watch as we do our thing. And yeah, we encourage you to do it at home or on the go.
Yeah, cool.
I want to do it. Watch Longbox live on Ustream. Just search out Longbox on Ustream.com.
All right, so we're back here on Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm, presented tonight by Riley's Brewing. Go get yourself a Sancho, or this Friday at Das Bierhaus, go hit yourself up the Worthog IPA.
And less than 1,000 bottles, apparently, so it's pretty rare.
And you would be the guy who would know all about that. You travel and buy it.
I do. I go and seek it out, but, I mean, I'm not going to do that on Friday.
Okay. Our guest tonight, we got Claudio Urreas.
How you doing?
He's from C.a.K.e, the C.a.K.e Art Hop, and you'll have to help me out here a little bit. I know we got a whole long list of stuff, but let's just start simple. The C.a.K.e Art Hop being tomorrow night at, where are we at?
Starts at 5.
It starts at 5?
5 in the afternoon, goes to 9. It's an all-ages event. We do one every month. Art Hop is actually a program created by the Fresno Arts Council. And we're an official member. We're actually a nonprofit arts collaborative. We're a private club, but we do have one event a month, which is our ArtHop event, where we open up our doors to the public, and we bring in four to five different artists every month, two performers, be it hip hop or a DJ. And usually, if it's a DJ, we like to bring in records, because that's, you know, pretty rare nowadays. Everyone's playing off a laptop.
Let me stop you here for a second. I'm going to have to ask, what is an art hop? For a guy like me, I it's hopscotch for art?
Is it all in one building, or are there a bunch of... Daddy likes to literally hop from building to building.
Yeah.
Actually, art hop, again, is something that was actually going on prior to the Fresno Arts Council, from what I understand, and it's been going on for years before I even knew about it. But Fresno is a hub, if you will, of artistic talents, a lot of artistic talents, everything from music to visual arts. But people were having art shows here and there, and eventually they started organizing it and doing it one day, and Fresno Art Council went ahead and split it up between the southern and northern, I guess, areas. So Tower and Downtown is the first Thursday of every month, and the third Thursday of every month is the metropolitan area. But it's basically, if you're a venue and you want to be a part of this movement, if you will, you pay a membership fee to the Fresno Arts Council, then you become an official venue when they put you in their publications and promotions and such. And
so for the venues, it's kind of like a sponsorship type of thing where they get to be a part now of the downtown-ish group, whatever, gets a monthly promotion.
Exactly. There's some people that do it without being a member, and you can do that, you know, but...
What actually goes on?
At the ArtHop?
Basically, people open up their building or their venue to the public, and they bring in different artists, performers, and such, and they just basically put on a big art show. I've been booking and promoting for over 16 years in Fresno now, so I kind of like to go all out for our events. So we put a lot into it, like lights and.
How do you decide what kind of cake you serve?
As far as cake, it really depends on the, you know, what's in season. Cakes are in season, right?
I go cakes are always in season.
Always in season.
Settle down, Kenneth.
I haven't eaten in 3 days. I kind of want cake.
I've always been more of a pie kind of guy.
Cake is just to elaborate on that. You know, I don't want a bunch of people showing up. Hey, I want my cake.
Where's my damn cake?
Did you say cake?
You can have it, art, but you can't eat it.
I just showed up because it's cake.
CAKE is an acronym for Claudio and Kepri Enterprises. I'm Claudio. Kepri's my daughter. And,
it's a lie.
It's a dirty lie. It's true. It's true. I promise.
There are periods in there. That's the whole idea.
Yes.
Oh, I just wanted cake. I was promised cake, so I'm disappointed.
Jason, you got your moment. Shut up.
The closest thing that I guess we could provide was those crackers that we brought over.
And cheese.
Yeah. And box wine of delicious blush. That's the actual name of it.
It's like Kool-Aid.
That sounds like it's going to taste horrible. I'm sorry.
And quick prediction, by the end of the night, Cotty is going to have drank half of that.
And I'll have drank the other half. Let's go, Cotty.
The box wine twins.
All right, drunk of the night.
It's a tie.
How many venues typically a night are open and people running around looking at stuff?
Oh, just looking from here, there's at least, 40?
On the official list, it looks like there's about, right around 40.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah. Individual venues.
And again, not everyone is an official member, so this is just who participated.
Is the scene kind of like the Walking Dead of art people?
I would say so, just because a lot of the places are BYOB, and by the end of the night, that's kind of what it looks like.
At the end of the night, it looks like BYOB. Yeah, at the end of the night, it looks like the Walking Dead zombies everywhere. Yeah. But at the beginning of the night, you know, everybody's, you know, happy to be off work and having a beverage.
And then everybody's drunk off of those beverages.
That's about 7 o'clock. Well, yeah. It goes to 8 for a reason.
I noticed you got artists there, different vendors. Jay Escoval is going to be there doing custom stickers, T-shirts, and then you got live music.
Yeah, we're also going to have live painting by Chris Mungry. He paints live while the performers perform. And, the vendors we have are, one of the gentlemen that's showing up, Robert A. Hagar, he is a professional life coach. He also does tarot card readings, so he'll be doing life readings and such. He did it last time, and it was pretty awesome. I mean, people were walking away like, oh, my God. Yeah, and I'm kind of weird about stuff like that. As soon as they start talking to me, and the minute they start getting personal, I run the other way. But, you know,
it's like my dating life.
It's like, go to hell. Go away. I don't want to know.
Pretty much, yeah. I like surprises.
And not only all of that going on, you got some free food and hors d'oeuvres, or free refreshments and hors d'oeuvres there.
Oh, yeah. That's actually one of the standards. I mean, if you go to the Fresno Area Art Council and you look up the ArtHop and the rules and such.
So it's an awesome cheap date.
You can't charge, so all of them will be free. You'll never pay a cover or anything like that. And two, you need to provide some type of refreshment or hors d'oeuvres. You know? And it is... They try to keep it all ages in that sense. So it's cool. We get families that come in. I mean, with a bunch of kids and their grandmas and grandpas. And it's like, wow, this is cool. It almost feels like we're like the zoo for a day.
So don't get trashed before the ArtHop. Got it.
Yeah.
Well, you have to pick your spot. They're one of the more family-friendly spots. Yes. There are a couple that are a little less family-friendly.
Yes, that is true.
Kenneth only has a small selection of spots he can actually go to. So you're limiting
legally.
Him more.
Yeah. Art House is another venue if you guys want to check out, you know, awesome.
Calaveras and H?
Yes, and then there's the Broadway Studios is another one, which I highly recommend. K-Jewel puts on a pretty good one.
All places I've been and have had a blast and drank a lot of whiskey.
Oh, yeah. You know, sometimes we'll actually, you know, put out a bottle of wine if, like, someone will come and donate it. Because, again, it's like a kind of an unspoken
we're all like BYOB in the sense where everybody brings their own stuff. I mean, we provide water and refreshment, but there's people that bring in their own stuff.
Maybe the Dirty Dowdy podcast crew tomorrow night can just go walking around with our selection of food and box wine.
That's a scary idea.
You are more than welcome.
You won't get turned away. You won't get turned away by anybody.
Not at all.
No, sweet.
No autographs.
Kevin.
I don't think my questions are appropriate.
Oh, hold on. Speaking to the K.E. in the room, earmuffs. And she's got the headsets on.
There we go. Go ahead.
Hold on. Start repression now.
I feel like we're going to go from, like, you know, a nice little stroll in the park to getting hit in the face with some pretty raunchy questions that I've designed specifically for someone else.
All right.
However, can I get a volunteer? Not everyone at once. Now.
I'll be the volunteer.
All right. You're gonna read these questions because
I look this guy in the eye after saying these things.
Wait.
You see, I was under the impression there would also be an Amber, so they're kind of split for.
Oh, so maybe that's why she didn't show
if
up.
If you ask him,
now I get it.
To make this nicer, why don't you ask him the Amber questions, and then that way it's not offensive
there
at all.
There we go.
That's there we go. That works for me. Actually, those will be better.
I'm a thinker.
So mean it's an Amber alert.
So.
He goes straight there.
We are here, ladies.
She's not lost or missing. She's of age, so there's no Amber alert.
She's definitely not here.
She's definitely not here, though. All right, so Claudio, series question, drugs question mark.
I think that's a great question. I think that's implied in the BYOB.
Okay.
You
okay.
know, we're not the law, and we're not your parents, but please, you know.
He's saying, yeah, BYOB is, you know, that last B is, you know.
I see what he did. He also twisted the question. Mm-hmm.
It's not BYOH.
You're playing it safe, Claudio. I like it.
Bring your own bag.
I'm
of something.
Of whatever.
Yeah.
That's the way to do it.
What you do in the bathroom, you know. We don't have a camera in there.
No.
Or microphones.
Yet.
We might.
Or an Amber.
One day.
Speak about your own bathroom.
I'm speaking about your bathroom. I don't know about Dowdy's bathroom. No, I've not been in there.
It is pure and pristine.
There's an IP camera in the top left corner.
Yep.
The waterproof kind.
Mm-hmm. Underneath the lid.
So
super
that's
cold.
Why it's pristine.
Jason's bathroom is just a wall with a chain on it.
Need something to hold on to.
Yeah.
All right. Toss him another softball.
All right. So this one was intended for Amber, but what's for you? Serious question, Claudia. What's the worst thing about an orgasm?
Not having one.
Just not having one?
Yeah. Hmm. Have you ever faked an orgasm?
Pass.
And no comment. No comment. That's incriminating.
That is correct, sir.
For some reason, most girls are under the impression that guys can't fake an orgasm.
Most girls are dumb.
It's possible.
What's this last... I need you to... With this last question for Amber. Mm-hmm. The last word. Peen?
Yeah.
Peen?
How would you improve on the current stock model peen?
Yes.
I don't even know what that means.
It means penis.
Yeah, thank you.
So how would you improve on your current stock model penis?
What?
That's what Molstar wanted to ask you. Serious question.
You know, aside from the surgery that you had,
look at the eye.
I mean, no. Penis. Like, how would you improve your penis?
Protein comes out.
Or just
protein?
All.
Yeah, like racing stripes down the side.
But say it from a girl's perspective.
all right, and we're gonna skip that
protein.
Protein, pineapple, maybe. I don't know. Can I heard pineapple's good.
I think pineapple's correct.
Pineapple's
yeah.
Best
can
answer.
We get a ding?
Ding.
Thank you.
There we go. Ding.
Oh, if okay. So this is so if you go back in time to the day you lost your virginity, what would you tell yourself? Like the day. So that night, it's happening. That day, what would you tell yourself?
The Back to the Future for your virginity.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, for that particular scenario,
or just
in general, like particular scenario, I'd be like, not worth it.
It would be a nightly trip for me.
Usually isn't.
Well, you know, but that doesn't speak for the after.
You know, you got to get the first time out of the way, right?
Pretty much.
You know?
Yeah. You know, like that first couple messed up pancakes.
Yeah, exactly.
You just refer to sex as pancakes.
The first time you cook eggs, exactly.
Yeah, that too.
That's the extent.
First, but I wanted cake. Now I want pancakes.
So wait, you got to break a couple eggs to get laid?
Well, I guess you got to break a couple eggs for it to be good.
Okay, sure.
That makes sense, yeah?
No, the first, the first egg I cooked, I just threw the egg in the pot, so...
Hey. Oh, the first time I made eggs, I burned myself really bad.
Are the eggs in vitro?
No, they were in oil. They were in oil, and I dropped them from really high.
I know someone who, when they lost their virginity, they burned themselves really bad, but that's another story.
Then my mom came home and beat me.
Like, what?
Well, she was mad. Wait, she said her mom cooked afterwards. Her, no, oh,
so when he burned himself cooking the eggs.
Okay.
Yeah, so the repression didn't work for you.
All right, so this is Alex asking Molestar's questions. So they're going to call that done.
Thank you, Alex. You did a fine job.
He's like, please, God, be done.
What's the best thing you've ever seen on at an ArtHop?
Oh, fire. Fire spinning. Fire flame breathing, eating, all kinds of
stuff. Is that a normal?
I know a couple of the aerials. Troops. And then the aerial dancing with the curtains and stuff. Yeah.
So really like full-on Cirque du Soleil stuff going on too.
Yes. Now you got people that are very creative that come out and they build stuff and people that dress up and out of nowhere. Nobody hires fire spinners, but they're always there and it's freaking awesome.
I know a couple of the troops that go out there, the ArtHop.
Yeah.
The fire spinning.
Yeah, they get a little wild. Yeah. So, serious question. Where are we going to find you at tomorrow?
Oh, I'll be at C.a.K.e.
So, how are we going to find C.a.K.e?
1570 North Washon, northeast corner of Washon and McKinley. We're south of McKinley. So, big red building. We're going to have a big 4x8 Marilyn Monroe painting donated by Jason Escobar. He's donating it for the day, actually. I wish we could keep it, but we're going to put it on the side of the building on the Washon side. So, as soon as you pass by, you can see that big red building with the Marilyn Monroe painting on the side, like neon orange.
It doesn't have any copper in it, does it?
No copper. Okay, otherwise, it would be gone. It would be gone. You know, it's funny. The reason I got this building, I do this arts festival. Like I said, I used to book and promote for, you know, bands and such. But I got this building because I used to book this arts festival at Babylon, and they stole the copper.
Oh, yeah.
And so they busted a water main and flooded the stores upstairs.
They were trying to steal copper, and they just took the steel pipe, cut into the water main there, which flooded the whole... So they got nothing for the metal, and they flooded and destroyed and ended a great venue.
It was like $50,000. No, it was like $250,000.
Well, from what I understand, all the insurance money that the owner got, or the guy that was leasing the spot, it would have been... only 25% of what it would take.
So he took the check and went peace out.
Yeah, he's actually reopening up Blockbusters, used to be on Olive.
So he's moved up to ground level.
Yeah, pretty much.
Tell me someone shot that asshole that did that.
I don't know.
He's probably dead now, the guy that took the water. Yeah.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
He didn't make great life choices. I can't imagine him living another year.
Good.
I say the same about Kenneth every year. All right, well, Claudio, thanks for coming in. Make sure tomorrow night, people, check out the C.a.K.e. ArtHop. We'll post all the links on our website and on our Facebook pages. Anything you want to say?
Yeah, we got a website. It's cakeworldwide.com, and it has all our information there. Or you can just go to our Facebook page. You know, same thing. Look us up, Claudio and Capri Enterprises. But the easiest links would be just go to cakeworldwide.com.
Sweet. That's... I'm sorry, I was waiting for my Oscar moment here for my sound man.
Go ahead and cut him off, sound man.
I want to hear him stop talking immediately.
I'm going to finish.
I think you lost him on Tumblr.
Yeah. Go ahead. With that, we're going to take a quick break. We got a wonderful segment that I've been thinking of forever since last night. Hey. And it's going to totally change your world as far as online dating and trying to... online dating or real world dating, which I know if you're listening to the show right now that it's online, will help you out. Kenneth, this is important for you.
Yeah.
Because this whole segment is really based around you and Jason's dong.
That's great.
Yeah, so we'll be back. Check us out on Periscope. We'll be it's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast here on Longbox.fm.
You're listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm.
Dating is hard, and we here at the Dirty Dowdy Podcast want to empower you with knowledge to aid you in your quest for love. And we have an expert. These are Jason's Tinder Moments.
All right, so my brainchild from last night, drinking, smoking, and hanging out with a 25-ounce dong, decided to put together a segment based on dating, social dating, real-life dating, all that.
This music sounds like the soundtrack to syphilis.
Which is perfect for this segment, apparently.
Yes.
That's all of Tinder, actually.
So, again, if you want to participate in any of this, hashtag on Twitter, DDP Podcast, and give us your thoughts. You could also call in 492-0450. We may answer. It depends on where we're going.
Please now, give us your best pickup lines.
Best pickup lines, that's what we're looking for? I think that's a starting point for this, right?
That's where I think anybody could take advice from.
Okay, now, Jason, being that I live with you, I see the train of poontang that goes through this house on a weekly basis.
That kind of worries train. Me. Is it like a freight train, or is it more like a couple cars? And maybe?
Or is it a train wreck?
It's a straight train wreck.
Okay. You can't help but stare.
Now we're getting somewhere.
Oh, what does that mean? There's caboose all over the place?
That's right.
Now, I've witnessed him in his actions and what he does. He is a tender man. And he knows how to throw out those initial lines. They, hey, how you doing? Now, Kenneth, being that you you didn't even swing and miss last week. You just tripped on the way to the plate with a girl who was giving you an inside the park.
She was going to pay me $100 to bang you.
Yeah.
You cost me $100.
How did you not go home with that?
You don't have $100.
I would have if you'd put out like
she
every other
does.
Man
I
on
know
Earth.
I have $75.
That's not important.
Well... Kenneth, get your notes ready for this. Jason, take it away.
All right. Well, I threw this together about 10 minutes before the show, so there's no rhyme or reason to it.
So do the rest of us.
It's also
no pressure.
Also like his Tinder chats.
Right. So I feel it's appropriate, spur of the moment. All right. So I would start with, it's important to establish intent early on. You need to know where you're going or trying to go.
Kenneth, you're not writing a damn thing.
I don't have to right now.
So intent.
I should be taking notes.
Long, happy, healthy relationship. Would that be the intent?
No.
No.
That is
not Jason's
what
thinking more along
for.
The pickup line of, hey, wanna fuck?
I mean.
Not quite so blunt.
It's yeah, more really like, subtle. It's more like, are you from heaven? Because will you have sex with me? But
hey, pizza and a fuck. What, you don't like pizza?
It's more like, do you want to come over and watch Netflix, and we can see where that goes.
Yeah,
but let's come over and
now,
chill.
We'll watch the most romantic movie in the world, Team America: World Police.
That's right. It gets so wet.
Okay, so wet. How do you normally start this?
Well, I like I said, it's important to know your intent early on, and it's more important to know your audience. Just like it is in stand-up comedy. If you look through a profile, if you actually read it, nobody reads profiles on Tinder, but if you do read the profile and you try to find something, you want to try to find something that stands out, that doesn't, she's not getting 50 messages a day about. But if a girl has a bunch of hashtags and she's talking in text speak and isn't doing it ironically.
She's dumb.
Yeah. You don't want to use the highbrow humor. You want to dumb it down. You got to know what you're going for.
Like dick and a dollar sign usually does it.
I mean,
or the emoji eggplant.
That's what I go for. So if I see an eggplant emoji, I know I'm in. But I say
he's in.
If she has a witty profile and she has
tips and tricks,
lots of smart sounding stuff, then you generally, it's a good idea to open with an awful but clever pun. Smart bitches love puns.
Mm-hmm.
So. Mark that down. Hashtag smart bitches love puns.
That's right.
Hashtag puns.
Octopus. Hashtag.
But
eggplant emoji.
Hashtag shut the hell up, Alex.
Go. honesty,
Hold
though.
Hold on, he's about to spill it.
I was going to say, honesty is almost always the best policy.
Nope.
You'd be surprised how many girls are down for whatever as long as you're just straight up and forward with it. You don't want to go with it. You just have to have a decent amount of tact. If you see a girl that has something in her profile that says not here for hookups, what it really means is I'm here for hookups, but don't ask me to hook up. So you just have to figure out a way.
You got to circle back.
Yeah. You got to ask it without asking it. which is what I'll address later. But
like when you're trying to buy drugs from someone, you're not sure if they're a cop.
Right, right, exactly. Yeah. Hey, are you a cop?
Hey, do you have the white China?
No. Okay.
Or saying to them, you know, this is entrapment, right?
You can't prove it. There, you gotta remember though that another important thing to remember is that you have to stand out. On a place like Tinder, there's about a 10-to-1 ratio of dicks to pussy. So you really have to stand out or set yourself immediately apart from the crowd.
It's like the Dirty Dowdy Podcast right there.
That's right.
Yeah.
So there's
got to be honest. Yeah.
You got to remember that the girl you're messaging, there's always going to be about 20 guys hotter than you sending her messages too. So, you know.
Yeah, that's usually the case, sounds like.
That's okay. There. That's okay. You just have to think of something that's going to set you apart from those 20 douchebags that are like, hi, how are you?
Like, I have LSD?
Sometimes.
Hey, do you have change for millions?
See, now, the thing about Tinder is you can find exceptions to everything because the numbers are so large of how many people are on there that just by the law of averages saying LSD, do you want some? You're going to get... I mean, you got a big enough fishnet, you're going to collect something.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
But it seems like quantity over quality.
Yeah, but that's why you're on Tinder.
That's all of Tinder, yeah, basically.
Okay, Jason's approach to this, he's not a sniper.
No, he's a shotgun.
He's got a sawed-off shotgun, and he's walking through the mall.
I don't think it's very sawed-off.
It's like a 25-ounce shotgun.
But it doesn't sound
like
honest, a lot.
Let's be honest, that sounds like a small shotgun.
Yeah, like I told you.
In that respect.
He's
but
using
12 you really have
buckshot.
To...
That's what he's
this
using.
This bottle...
It's not... Yeah, no. It's not buckshot. It's not a slug. It's birdshot. It's going to spread everywhere.
Yeah.
Also like the girl that's with Jason.
Right, right. That's exactly right.
That's the point.
Which is... That leads me into another topic. Is you just have to know your approach. If you want to go with the shotgun approach, you just message everybody and you go with whatever bites. But if you go with the picky...
Or itches or burns.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean...
Gotta get that new ointment.
There's Planned Parenthood downtown in case.
If you have a Tinder profile, you probably have a stockpile of antibiotics.
That's a given.
You should.
You should. I don't think it says that on the site.
Maybe
but,
a condom or two?
Real quick,
do you have a standing appointment with the local Planned Parenthood? Like you just come in every Thursday and like, hey, Jason.
They just let him in.
I actually do. I just show up there every week and they're just like, oh, you're back.
They
and
just
I'm
go
like,
on in.
They're like, we're really surprised you lived another week.
They're just trying to hand him a bag of condoms. He's like,
like, you know you have everything, right?
You know you have
the all of it.
Like but it works, though, because it's like, I have everything, so nothing can get through.
The HIV hasn't taken its toll yet. Go ahead and go in for some more.
Are you saying all the diseases are fighting for dominance
right
now? Since
right,
the stalemate?
They're all trying to get through this little door, and none of them can get out, so like it protects myself.
You're saying STDs are playing capture the flag with your dick.
Your immune system has a no vacancy sign? Is that what's...
I have acquired it over my dead body.
The trick?
The flag is what I try to plant. But that's where I try
to go
for.
You only need to get the tip in the ground.
It's more of a seed, but go on with your tip.
Right, right. So I was going to say that you always want to open, if we're going to actually say some real advice, I don't know if we're talking real advice, but you always want to open something with something different. You don't ever, ever, ever want to say, hi, how are you? Because...
Sound like a serial killer.
Right, right.
Hello.
Well,
Ed Gein.
And this is why, again, Kenneth has failed on every dating
event. You can't say hello, my pretty.
Ed Gein has a different meaning to me. Sorry.
See, now Kenneth has so much going for him until he starts talking and typing things and expresses himself.
So I'll just not talk.
See, now we're getting some.
I really would love that.
Blind question marks and exclamation points. And
can we turn his mic off?
I think you should just have Jason answer for you. That probably even.
I'll just
have
my fucking
rods right there.
I think Jason has Tinder out right now.
I actually I have an hourly rate that you can pay me, and I'll answer your Tinder for you.
I don't know if I want to pay you.
You should pay him.
Well, I don't know, Kenneth. Do you want to ever get laid
again?
It's, again.
Yeah, but for a guy who walks into Planned Parenthood with the HIV, I don't know.
Look, now is not the time to be picky.
Allegedly.
I don't know. I think it could be that picky.
You're 48 years old and you need to have sex.
You really got to like picky pick and choose your battles.
Picky is not an option for Jason.
Right, right. Pick, and Kenneth. I mean, that's part of the thing is you just have to be aware of your strengths and weaknesses.
There are plenty of fish in the sea, right?
Right.
You got to give them the opportunity
well,
to say
if
no.
If it walks and crawls, right?
Right. Right.
The only picking he does is the crabs out of his pubes. That's where he draws
hey,
the line.
Hey, I have a comb for that.
The crab walking.
It's actually the only comb I can use. But
they battle the comb.
Kenneth, more listen, less talk.
That leads back to you want to sell your strengths. You don't want to open with something like "Hi, how are you?" and just be sending this girl a message that she's heard 20 times already that day. But unfortunately for me, there's no real way to say "Hi, I have a huge dick. How can I
help you?"
Unless that's your profile pic.
There's no way. I've tried 50 different ways, and there's no way you can say that without sounding like every other guy that tries to say the same thing. I wouldn't recommend it, unfortunately.
Well,
so,
luckily, no one here in this room has that problem.
You know what you should do is lay out $100 bills end yourself. To end and then flop it across and take a picture of that.
That could be my next picture that I put up on
my I'd probably say I'm black from the waist down.
That is what I've said on multiple occasions.
You want to go honesty, you should get out the tape measure and also today's newspaper. Kind of go Harvey Lee Oswald with it.
like it's an ISIS hostage negotiation.
Need to have
well, we all know those.
Well, wait a minute. What's the newspaper for? Just
it gets
to prove
off, right?
You get the
proof
date.
Of the date.
Yeah. Okay.
But how do you know it's you? You have to have like a little.
Well, that's a hard picture to find on the spot, man.
You got to open up her profile on your computer and then stand in front of it and take a picture of you holding the newspaper in front of the computer
and then
screen.
You have her profile on one screen and then Pornhub on the other.
There you go.
That's too much. You got to have something saved that you can have on the fly while you open your fly. But
ooh.
Ooh.
Hey.
Hey.
No.
No. No. Yeah. Well, it's still a work in progress, so You can add comments, you can add tips, but as long as it's just a tip.
It's all trial and error, but is there enough single women here in the Central Valley though? It's
kind of that goes back to what Dowdy
playing
was working
the numbers
on.
Is kind of difficult, right?
I let Dowdy actually do the Tindering for me on one occasion, and that was a one occasion kind
of
thing.
It was fun.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
He swiped right.
Oh, you're going to be a daddy.
she surprisingly did not, she was not interested after I got done chatting. Oh,
somehow yeah. I got unmatched afterwards. Wow. It was going really well at first, and then I handed my phone to Dowdy, and it turned into O.J. Simpson talk, I believe. Well, I'll give him some credit.
this was solid. Screw all of you.
I'll give him some credit. He knew a lot of things with the younger audience that I would not know.
OJ,
I believe he. Well,
did he mess that with the glove? Don't fit. You must have quit.
Nope. It was smart.
That's what I say when there aren't magnums available.
I said. I said something about taking out for drinks or something, and I said I would buy her Nicole Brown Simpson, and she said, "I don't know what's in that." And I said, "OJ."
But then you kept it going.
I thought you were going to tell her, "I'm not going to rape you, but if I do, here's how I'm going to do it."
And at the end of the night, I'll stab you
with my dick.
I don't remember what I said, but I just kept referencing the whole murder thing.
You really kept pushing it.
Oh man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could see how that could be a turnoff.
Yeah. I mean, it was funny the first couple too, but then after like the third or fourth reference that she didn't get, it kind of turned into weird.
It's her fault
awkward.
For being stupid.
But,
it really is.
But again, that goes back to knowing your audience. So
I was
if you're
about
go-
to say that.
If you're going for stupid, that's okay. You just have to know how to talk to stupid.
Yeah, you can't go, "Hello, moron."
You should have just messenger # herpy and pancakes.
Which is also what's on my profile.
That's your profile name, isn't it? Herpes and pancakes.
Except they never get the pancakes.
Oh, you thief, you.
Yeah. Just like the cake from the ArtHop. It's a lie.
The cake is a lie.
Yeah, that was a jip, wasn't it?
It really was. I was disappointed. But anyway, so going back to the different approaches that you can go with, it's okay to have a couple copy and pasted introductions as long as it's not too obvious. You don't want it to be something that she obviously can tell was for somebody else.
if it's some general joke or something that could apply to anybody, you can usually get away with it.
Do you have a general joke you usually lead
I
with?
Do. I would love I do. To know that. And I have a whole page that I'm about to get to.
I have a question.
Somehow I think that Jason's trying to sell something because all this time I'm hearing all this
Send
stuff.
Send me your money and I'll change your life.
Yeah, it's like, hold on. You got to buy my manual.
Yeah.
But I'm going to give you
I have a question for you, Jason.
I'm going to give you some tidbits until I get there.
How is something that took you 10 minutes to write taking you 30 minutes to explain?
Hey, this is magic. Don't ruin it.
It goes back to the whole being interrupted thing that you have to deal with all the time.
Shut
on this.
Up.
Right.
Yeah, I do talk a lot of shit on this, so go ahead.
But it went back to the we've
talked
about.
You're making most
of
this shit up right now.
Don't lie. Yeah, I mean, you have to be good on your feet.
It does kind of sound like he's making shit up.
My handwriting.
It sounds like he's not giving us his secret recipe
I've witnessed
here.
All of this, so I'm telling you guys, if you want to get your penis wet at any point in your life.
Got to get your dick wet.
Get your ears on this.
It's his 12 steps.
I don't want to get
If you put it in the ear hole, that's also oral.
I was going to say, I don't want to get my ear on his wet dick, so let's go.
All right. Let's move it along. I'm kind of anxious to know the entire
Yeah, what's your
the entire recipe?
Well,
let's toss out the jokes, yeah.
I've given away a couple, but
you should start over from the beginning.
There's golden. Some gold in here. It's scattered between it, but
you wrote "Listen, Kenneth."
Yes, listen, Kenneth. That it is actually something I wrote down.
Oh man,
you motherfucker!
The important thing is to have fun and have a decent amount. You have to have confidence, but you just can't be too cocky. It's fun to ride that line between confident and cocky. But
what if you have no confidence because you don't have a big cocky?
Or coming from somebody that has a 25-ounce cocky.
I know. Well,
you got to fake it until you make it. That's always been my rule.
So once she's in the room, she's already done.
Right.
Okay.
I have talked
to some...
A steady stream of drinks is probably what's going to help you out.
Would you like some more?
Some DHB in those drinks doesn't hurt either, but that's something
Cosby
else.
Then.
Oh.
Would you like some Jell-O?
Two Cosbys.
Okay. We're going back to the Bill Cosby approach now. I don't recommend that.
It's bad for careers.
I'm not down for that either.
It all depends on how you want to start. Like I said, it goes back to knowing your audience. So if you want to start off innocent, you can, but I wouldn't recommend it. Because this is Tinder, and anybody that goes to Tinder and thinking that it's for anything else but what it's actually for.
You are searching those papers so hard right now.
He's it's looking like, for the note he had for this specific moment. He's
that's
got like 6 pages here.
It's like going to a buffet, a sausage buffet, but you're saying you're only there for the salad. It just doesn't work.
There's a long way to go for
he
that.
He went into a ton of effort to write that one.
Yeah. You should have really just said, people on Tinder
That was what
want
he thought
bang.
About for 10 minutes.
It was.
I think I'm officially going to change my name through court to Magic Johnson.
That would be amazing.
It would be, as long as you can keep the AIDS off the paperwork. But anyways,
so let's hear those openers. Okay, let's.
Jason,
enough
of
the
advice.
Right, can
we
give us some good? Openers.
Give us something. Yeah, give openers to someone like Kenneth.
Do we want PG openers or do what kind of openers?
We want them all. We want all the good ones.
Run the gamut of them.
Well, okay. I mean, all the good ones, not the.
Well, the one. How about
there,
the ones that have worked?
Okay.
How about
I've given a couple to actually one of our guys here, Kevin.
Yes.
But I don't believe they actually did. Did you have any success?
Not yet, but I'm not doing quite the shotgun approach. I'm a little more picky.
That's your
sniper
problem.
Shotgun.
Yeah, so my success has not been quite as storied as Mr. Slots.
It's not as quantitative.
Yeah. But
you go for quality.
I've got a purpose. And
Are
then
you
I get
Morpheus?
A lot of. Well, actually, there was. There's a great website called Reddit. There's a subreddit called Tinder, and it's the best of Tinder. There's one guy who did a Morpheus, and he had a red pill in one hand and a blue pill in the other.
Uh-oh.
You've seen this one, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Take the red pill, you'll wake up in your own bed. Take the blue pill, we'll see how deep your asshole goes.
Which brings to me to one of my pickup lines, which is...
I'm writing that one down.
I like to sometimes open with, my dick died, can I bury it in your ass?
Does that work?
Historically, no.
Has it ever worked?
But...
said does, historically, which means at some point, yes.
Yes, there's been a few occasions, but I wouldn't recommend opening with that.
Okay, think back to your last five triumphs, so Tuesday.
Okay.
What was the opening line on each of those?
I'll pull up my last greatest feat here. I opened with, there's so much talk here. What did the egg say to the boiling water?
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm. She said, ha, 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 oh, dear, I don't know what. I said, it's going to take me a couple minutes to get hard. I just got laid by this chick.
And then the follow-up.
And then she says, ha, 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 you get points for originality, which goes back to not saying, hi, how are you? And then she followed up with, this is why I opened with this. She went to, so it only takes a couple minutes? And then, how many minutes are we talking here?
Oh, man.
So it really...
That had the potential of backfiring on you.
It does, but as long as... you've got a 50-50 chance, and those are odds I'm willing to take.
You should have said, don't worry, it's plural.
I think I might take this one to the Art Hop tomorrow. So I think I'm having some.
Oh, we're just joining worlds all over.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we need to have a skit based on that.
Hopefully she's not listening right now because I did tell her about the podcast.
Oh, and this, man, now this she's gonna totally, know your game plan.
This could totally fuck everything up.
You left a paper trail.
All six of your pages,
Miss Hardboiled. If you're paying attention, why don't you send a message right now so we know?
Please call
4920450 if you're planning on banging Jason tomorrow night.
Yeah, he's trying to get you pregnant. You should know that.
I think she already has two, so I don't think she's on that route.
Well, I mean, if she has
which
two,
brings me back to
she
the
puts out.
Right. If she has two, she's willing to go lower in the scale. You can get much hotter if you go for the ones that already have kids, because they have to settle lower. Which,
and that's where you fit in.
I mean,
barely.
That's very confident, Jason.
Right. I mean, it's just knowing where you stand.
So barely that it's a stretch.
That's what she said.
Mark.
Okay.
I do want to bring up that Jason, not only is he quite the expert of this, and his success ratio is pretty good. The other thing is he hits everyone. And this has to go with when he was
not very selective then, Jason.
When he shows me like that, he gave me, because I've never seen the Tinder app, and so I'm swiping whatever left or right on this.
I'm just like right.
Wait a minute. So what's the max age? Like 65 or what?
You interrupted me, guest.
I'm sorry.
Shut up.
Oscar.
So turning my mic off now.
As I'm swiping all over the place, I got done, and I was like, "Where are the other ones?" And he goes, "Oh yeah, I've already hit the 50 mile radius."
What did the message come up on Tinder? It said you've exhausted all of your possible matches. Please try again later.
And so,
yep.
When a new match pops up,
that's when I get excited. It's like I get a chance to really spread my paint on the canvas.
Oh yes, a new blood, literally new blood.
And you explained it so well last night.
It's. I mean, if there are some telltale signs you should pay attention to, because if I get matched with a hot girl, 9 times out of 10, it's because she's new. And she doesn't know her potential yet.
So, and the creeper moves forward.
Right.
Early bird, man.
Mm-hmm. You got it. You got to take that worm. Shit and you got to put it on lockdown quick, because she doesn't know that she has so many other options yet.
Thousands
She's
of
like,
them.
And I got her.
That's why I said it. I almost blew us off tonight to go out with this girl just for that fact, so that she didn't get distracted by all the other dicks on Tinder.
So many dicks.
There's just a flock
it's
of dicks.
Just a sea of cock.
By the way, flock of dicks. Performing at Fulton 55 this Wednesday night.
Flock of dicks.
Hashtag sea of cock.
Hashtag flock of dicks.
I like flock of dicks.
So, I guess I can go back into the some of my examples here if you want to take notes, Kenneth.
Oh yeah, I got it.
Okay.
Use your examples in a way that would actually work for him. So you might need to rip that whole thing up and be creative.
I swear to God, Jason.
What was the name of the girl that was here last week? I can talk
Mariah.
To her.
Mariah.
Okay. So you could go up to Mariah.
Oh, yeah.
And be like, "Is your name Google, Mariah?" And she'd be like, "What? Why?" And be like, "Because you've got everything I'm searching for, But I wouldn't recommend that one. That's a tame one.
That's kind of lame.
That's a tame one. Lame, but yeah. It's lame.
It's kind of lame, lame for Mariah. Continue.
Yeah, it's lame. But like I said, I'm starting tame and I'm working my way up.
Yeah, Mariah does DVDA. Like
we need to start it. Okay,
you gotta hit the ground running.
Okay. I mean, you could try a couple other tame ones. Like,
no.
No. All right.
Why does Barbie never get pregnant?
Oh, because Ken always came in a different box. But I'm bummed.
Because he doesn't have testicles.
I gotta write that one down.
I got paid. I actually got paid to tell that joke on stage once, believe it or not. But
did it work?
No. Well, I got a beer, but I went home alone, so. No. I don't know.
Tough break.
You got to decide what works or not. I got a beer, so I think.
Hey, well,
works.
Let me ask you a question. Have you ever turned one down, like when you actually met in person?
No.
So a shotgun approach is more like a grenade. It's more like a suicide like grenade.
So you're in it for the long haul, then.
He's in it for the numbers.
I'm pretty sure my boss even called me a slut the other day.
Hashtag dick grenade.
Oh, there's no question. Anybody here think he's not a slut?
Yeah, he's a slut.
No, yeah, it's
he's a hoe bag.
You didn't have to bring that up. That was kind of mean.
He's a two bit under $10 hoe.
You know, every weekend I take a whole bottle of bleach and just shake it outside his door.
Yeah.
kind of like an exorcism of dick right there.
That's what I do on my toilet seat, just so if they sit down, I don't have to worry about sitting on that.
No, that's
what,
for
demons?
Them.
Yeah.
Finish this strong. Give me something good that Kenneth can
yeah,
can
let's
work
see
with.
Your worst one. Worst one?
Come on, you gotta have a top 10 worst. Come on.
Top 10 worst?
You gotta have one.
I mean,
he's like, I'm going for best.
What's the worst thing you've said that got you laid?
Ooh.
That would probably be, what's the difference between regular and anal sex?
Oh, no.
That was your starting line?
Yes. I opened with that before.
Were you drunk?
No.
Wait for the answer.
But
wait for the
she
answer.
She must have been drunk, though.
I got to hear it.
She was.
What's the answer?
It was, one makes your whole day, and the other makes your whole week.
Yep.
Wait,
wow,
sound
that's
guy.
That's
where's
that's
that?
Very deep.
Where's our ba-dum-bum?
You don't deserve it.
I'm disappointed.
Well, wait, it still got him laid.
another success, approach success that I like to try that really throws them off their game, that sets you apart from the crowd, is if you throw out a female pickup line and they don't know what to make of it. If you ask them, "Are you cat food?" and they're like, "Wait, what?" and it's because you're making my pussy hungry.
So you go with the confusion route.
You really got to just stand yourself out from the crowd.
The girl
all,
has no idea what just happened.
That's all it is. It's just
you stun them and
apart.
Then you go in for the kill.
Shock and awe, right? Shock and awe.
Yeah. Hashtag pussy hungry.
Right. Mm-hmm. To our ladies here in the room, what's the best and worst pickup lines that you've had? Cotty and Jenny.
I'm sorry. This whole conversation has just made me sad. You guys make me sad. I'm sorry. It's
welcome
so hard.
To the male world of online dating.
Jenny,
you don't realize.
Not on Tinder, so don't look at me when you say that shit.
this
oh, you're a guy like the rest of them.
Oh, fuck you guys.
This is what nature is.
Cotty and I can throw a rock and hit a guy. Fuck him. You guys have to try so hard.
We really
do. Not apparently. That's apparently not.
I mean, there's a lot. There's three pages of thought that goes into this.
We have no thought.
You said it like
you,
it was a lot.
Go.
More. Well, that's the dichotomy of the world. You know, you know, he can go and ask 100 women to have sex with him, and 8 might say yes, and that's 8% win, and that's a win. Because 8% is better than 0%.
You miss 100% of the shots you don't take.
Because yep. Women are
in the words
for
of
that
the
100%.
Great
Michael Scott.
Wayne Gretzky.
So are you.
Wayne Gretzky.
Wayne Gretzky.
I think he said that. Yeah.
Wayne Gretzky said that one.
He
yeah.
did.
8%, 8% success. And
that's better
baseball,
than 0%.
In baseball, that earns you like $10 million bucks a year or something.
Exactly.
Right? Exactly.
So $10 million and like STD treatment, and you're good.
And yet, Kenneth still can't get
but
to
you know,
the flight.
Fuck,
you know,
I want $10 million.
I don't think I want you to sit in my truck anymore, bro.
I mean, there were social experiments about that. You know, the guy walked around, asked, you know, an attractive guy, you know, not even, I mean, like, not.
Not as attractive as Dowdy.
Not as ugly as Chris Dowdy.
Thank you.
No one's that ugly.
Yeah. Dick.
I think he asked a girl, I know what video you're talking about, and I'm pretty sure he asked a girl, are you wearing space pants? Because that ass is out of this world.
He did. And then he asked her if if she would have sex with him, and she said no.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why.
Can't imagine.
I can't imagine. But no, but I mean, he walked around and asked 10 women, you know, they said no. A woman, and she was, I mean, like, she was like a solid 5.5. And she asked 10
she was,
dudes.
She was a total one.
No, she wasn't a one. She wasn't a one, you know, it wasn't a walking ham beast.
No.
His one.
I have a question.
Binary.
Okay, question.
What is a solid 5.5?
You know, I'm not going to bring up right now.
This is precisely why I have the binary system.
Five and a half?
No, but I mean solid implies that it's either a 5 or a 6. But then you're going 5.5. How the fuck is that solid?
Now you know math?
See, a 5 is she weighs more than you, and you really have to
5.5, you're not sure.
Right. 5.5, you don't know. 6 is she weighs less.
Yeah.
So that's really what it comes down to.
I'm sorry. I didn't get
one,
the scale.
One has
what's
a bag
the scale?
On her head, the other one
can
doesn't.
We don't want to know the scale.
Guys, we're gonna
but eight guys said yes. Actually, 2 guys did say no, but they turned out to be gay. So
let's carry this.
Go figure.
Okay.
Let's carry this on to the break. We go on Periscope. You check us out. It's a Dirty Daddy podcast.
The music.
Here on Longbox.FM.
Can I get one more?
Okay, one more. Go.
Okay.
Are you a magician?
No.
Because abracadam!
Get in on that shit,
all right,
ball!
Yeah. We're taking a break.
Yeah.
By the way, listen to the music here, the break music that we got, because this EDM heavy backbeat, this is what I hear coming out of Jason's room all the time.
I'm sorry, I just made all your listeners that were listening just go away.
Yeah, they're on your Tinder.
Christ.
Make it drop. listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.FM.
Righty. Now we're done with Jason's dick. Let's talk about Potter Pimps.
Yeah.
Kevin, you got a new game that you invented.
Oh, yes, I do. Yes, I have.
And
yes,
it's
I
about did. Your two favorite things.
Two
pot
of them.
And pimps.
Yes. And not that order. No, that order.
Are you sure?
Right order. It's yeah. probably that order.
You like pimps?
Well, there's a lot between pimps. Pimps is actually the bookends, is
yeah,
what
you
say.
Yeah, but I would
say
pot is probably up there on your top five of things.
Just like
life.
Sadness
actually,
is yours.
Two.
I'm having trouble picturing you at the pimp ball.
Yeah, he's right. I don't go to the pimp balls.
All right, explain your game.
just the pimp's ball.
Okay, so pot or pimp. Basically, I've got a nice little jumbled list here of names that are either going to be the name of a pot strain or the name of an actual pimp, and it is your duty to find out which is which.
You said
now,
duty.
Yes, I did.
Jason. A line you can use next time is
that one.
That
yeah,
one.
Yeah. Just crack up at the person.
Yeah,
in front of
crack up and move away. Yeah.
It's my duty to please that booty.
I will use that tonight, just for you.
All right, thanks.
All right, so let's do it this way. I've got everyone's names written down. Let me make sure I got this right. Dowdy, Jenny, Alex. I didn't get your name, but I wrote Righty McGoatee because you're on my right side.
He's goat. Yeah, that works.
Powder, Keith, and Cotty. Everyone accounted for?
Actually,
fuck it,
Jose.
I'll take Keith.
Jose.
Yeah. Keith.
I'll just write Jose instead.
It's not the first time I've been fucking called Keith.
All right, so the first name.
But when it comes to women, you've never been called.
Whoa.
First name, Jorge Diamond. Pot or pimp? Go, Dowdy.
Jorge Diamond?
Jorge Diamond.
It's either a Mexican porn star or pot.
It's going to be one or the other.
That's
the name of the
game.
Yep.
I think you have to pick one or the other.
It's not one or the other. It is.
I got to go with pimp.
Let's go pimp. With pimp. Jenny.
I'm going to say pot.
Alex.
I'm going to say pimp. I'm going to have to go with Dowdy on that.
Righty. Jose.
I'm going to say pot.
Okay. Jason.
I thought my name was Powder.
Powder. That's okay. What I said.
Whatever the there fuck your name is.
Open your ears, man.
All right. I think that's probably
stalling.
Stupid stoner pot.
You're so high right now.
He's just like, I'm smoking it right now.
I never want to know the name of it. I just want to know if it works.
Again, just like his Twitter or Tinder.
Keith.
Can it be Keith McSadcock?
See, I actually wrote Kenneth, but when I read it, I thought it'd be funny if I called you Keith. No, I wrote Keith. That's right. I actually thought your name was Keith for a minute. Like when I wrote this, too. So go ahead.
He's so sad right now.
We say pimp.
Pimp.
You're so uninterested.
I'm going to say pimp.
Cotty.
I want to hear the name again.
Oh my God, it begins.
Jorge Diamond.
Jorge Diamond.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go with pot.
Okay. Raise your hand if you said pimp. You're wrong.
Fuck you.
It is indeed damn. Pot.
Wow. Story
I told
of my
you.
Life.
That's crazy.
You blame me for being high, but I got it right.
Beautiful glistening colas inspired Dutch breeders to name this strain after their friend and one of our favorite cultivation gurus, Jorge Cervantes. Jorge Diamond shines star bright, packs a crystalline punch, and what stony girl doesn't want to sparkle?
Is this like pot that's bottled in a wine bottle that's got the label on
the
back?
I want
the
Dutch know.
You could be like that. You could be like that pot connoisseur.
They've got Amsterdam,
that
know.
Could tell you like what year it's from and what vineyard.
What do they do? Take the pot and like
smell it
and then put it in their mouth and whisk it around a little bit. They're like,
maybe it comes in a wine box, a pot box.
That'd be classy.
You'd become a pothead real quick.
maybe it all comes right. in a potpourri box.
We're going to do more of a lightning round kind of thing. So we got to do little snappies, snappy answers. Right, our second snappers. Name, Crazy Jack Fatness. Cotty, go.
What?
Crazy Jack Fatness, pot or pimp?
Pimp.
Keith, Kenneth, Kyle. Faster.
Pimp. God damn it. Pimp. That's pimp, god damn it.
Agreed, that's definitely a pimp.
Mr. Jose.
I'm going to say pot.
Alex.
I'm going to go pimp.
Ooh.
I'm going to say pimp.
Pimp.
Raise your hand if you said pimp. You're correct.
All right.
Yay.
What's now, the score?
I've got one point.
I'm two for two.
Two for two.
I got one.
Who had pimp right there? Dowdy?
Yep.
Jenny?
Yeah.
Alex?
The only person who didn't was Jose.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a bummer.
Oh, Jose, sorry.
I don't know any better.
The one time that sound makes sense.
Starting with Dowdy, Holy Bobby, pot or pimp? It's harder than it sounds, huh?
There's so many other things that are jumping around.
Sounds like a European English pimp or something.
I'm not even going to say anything.
I didn't hear it. What was it?
Holy Bobby.
And now all I can picture is King of the Hill, so I'll go pimp. Holy Bobby.
I think it's pot, but I want it to be a pimp so much that I'm going to say pimp.
I'm going to go with pot.
I'm going to go with pimp this time.
Pot.
I'm going to say pot.
Hmm. I'm going with pot.
Pimp it is.
Yeah. Ding.
Damn it. Wow. Well, fuck wow. My life.
Holy Bobby has given us, has graced us with some relationship advice. On the subject of opposite attraction.
Oh,
now,
really?
Yes.
Oh, man.
Quote, dig this here. A lot of folks smile and say opposites attract, not realizing that will probably lead to a very bad breakup. See? He's right.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Like when I had to cut loose my bottom bitch because she was a vegan.
True.
She was too different. She too hard to feed. She couldn't never order what was on the menu like normal hoes. Hell, after a while, it was too much hassle, so I fired her ass. She had to go out loud. End quote.
I love how you read it.
I read it exactly how it was written.
Like, I really feel like his presence.
I don't even feel
room.
Bad that I'm losing. Go ahead.
That made it worth
all right,
it.
So everyone gets 2 points, because I'm not going to keep score anymore.
Too much work.
All right, starting back over at Cotty. Beast mode, pot or pimp?
Shit.
Fire away. I'm going to say pot.
Kenneth.
I'm going to say pimp.
Powder.
Pot.
Jose.
Pot.
That's pot.
I'm going to say pimp.
Pot.
I want to put some beast mode in my mouth.
So what was the answer before we respond
to that? I like how we got a decent mix here. Beast mode is indeed pot.
Told you.
It's a football player.
I know my pot.
Buck.
A local reviewer wrote, I tried this because of the sexual reviews. Well, it does make you horny.
Reviews. Okay.
After taking this, I ended up having a 1 hour hard on. I smoked this alone, wanting just a calm relaxation, and instead it made me want to have sex. With no sex partner around, I had to masturbate to online porn. Now, that's a sad story.
I could see him being furious during that.
Yeah. Just furiously masturbating.
Masturbating with his own tears, his lube.
He's angry. He's angry.
Angry tears.
Yeah. All right, we're gonna start it off.
It's a very lonely night. Yes.
Hashtag angry tears.
Do you know about this, Jose?
I have no clue.
Do you know about this, Kenneth?
No.
Our next one. Long. We're gonna start with Jose.
Oh.
Chocolope.
Oh man, that's pot. That's gotta be pot.
No way,
I'm sorry.
Oh, that's pot.
Let's move it down to the right, Alex.
There's no self-respect.
Say it again.
Can you say that again? Chocolope. We'll start, please.
Chocolope.
Chocolope.
Can you say it?
Can you use it in the sentence?
like a chocolate cantaloupe.
Apparently,
can you spell it for me? Can you really spell that for me?
Can you use it in a sentence?
Yes. The sentence is, the name is Chocolope.
Isn't that like a rabbit with like horns or
chocolate,
something?
Chocolate horns?
No, that's
Chocolope. Spelled
C-H-O-C-O-L-O-P-E.
Didn't care.
So,
didn't care.
Is it going to be like a black guy with horns? I'm going to go pot.
All right. Jenny.
Going to say pot?
Dowds. I've never called you that before, Mr.
I'm just going pimp.
Dowds.
Pip, and can we also slide in with name that race?
I think this time we can.
Bonus round?
Bonus point, bonus point.
Cotty.
I say Pimp.
No. I mean,
no,
sorry.
We have our answer.
Let's get to the end first.
I'm going to say pot.
That's what she said.
And powder.
I'm going to say black pimp.
I'm disappointed in you, powder. That was obviously pot.
Damn it.
Wow.
Jose was 100%
that's crazy.
Correct.
Wow. I got one right.
A minty C.a.K.e. cross of OG chocolate Thai and cantaloupe. That's.
What?
Obviously misspelled. I'm sure they meant cantaloupe.
What the fuck word was that?
They wrote cantaloupe, haze, chocolope.
Maybe the cantaloupe was on pot.
Maybe it's cantaloupe because it's like cannabis.
The author of
cantaloupe.
This article couldn't spell.
Nope, the pothead grabbed it.
Chocolope is as scrumptious as its name. We'd like to smoke a bowl of it with a glass of cold milk on the side, please.
What?
It sounds pleasant.
Wow. So it was a black person that came up with it. Got it.
Ken, starting with you. Poochie love. Pot or pimp?
I'm going to say pimp.
Cotty.
Pimp.
Doubts. Pot?
Pimp.
Hey, can you say it again?
Poochie love.
Poochie love?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I'm going to go pimp.
I'm going to go with pimp as well.
Pimp.
Ooh, this one almost got all of you. Pot.
Really?
Yeah!
Poochie Love is
If I ever become a pimp, I'll take that name.
That's
I'll
a good name, yeah.
Poochie Love.
That would have fooled me, too.
Yeah.
They can't trademark it because it's
Can you get that on
so.
A name tag at your next job?
Yeah, I know.
Poochie Love.
That'll be my nickname.
The rest of this week, he's called Poochie Love at work.
What up, Poochie Love?
That's a nickname we're sticking to.
Oh,
Poochie Love is a solid daytime choice, but save it for later in the day because you might want a nap.
By the way, Kevin has all of these in his house.
This sounds like a pot menu.
That's a pot or pimp menu.
There has been more pot than pimp, right?
This is originally this where this so article far? Originated.
Well, it's not 50-50.
I'm already going with pimp on the next answer.
Let's start with Jenny over there. Jenny, Larry D.O.G.
That's a pimp.
Alex.
I'm gonna have to agree. Pimp.
I'm going to go with pimp.
Powders.
I already answered. I said pimp.
Oh, thank you.
He said it before you started.
Mr. Ken.
I know it's a pimp, but too many people are saying it, so I'm going to say pot.
Cotty.
I think pimp.
It's so obvious it's pot.
Why is it so obvious?
Because it's too obvious to be a pimp's name, and you're
really
too smart
is.
For this.
I appreciate that. And you're correct.
Yes. Well,
the giveaway was the OG.
Damn it.
Yeah, a little worried about
that. The D did throw it out. But yeah, Larry D.O.G. Larry O.G. is a hybrid consisting of Lemon Larry O.G., Mother Plant, and a SVVVV, a lot of V's, O.G. Kush F3. Why did they... Does it matter?
What the
fucking
fuck?
Weed. Just say weed.
You know what I miss? Is back in the days when you just get high.
Yeah. Now you're high to talk about it.
Kevin's quote. Why say weed.
why are we getting the chemistry rundown here?
This is just the reviews that these particular strands got. The Lemon Larry Cut is a famed Southern California OG clone, which is known for having more of a sativa effect than many OGs, as well as a very citrus-heavy flavor palette.
Did you say clone?
Yeah.
Somewhere
what
along the lines.
What is it a clone of?
OG.
This next
Bubba
several
Fett
of them weren't you paying attention?
This next word that I'm gonna say.
Let's start with Alex. Alex Diamond Bradley.
Oh gosh.
Oh, he was great in Silver Lining. Or that movie.
No, that's not. It's not the same guy. But Diamond Bradley. It sounds like Diamond David Lee Roth. I'm gonna have to go with it's a pimp. That's a person.
I'm gonna go with pimp as well.
I'm saying pimp, but the last three times have been wrong. I'm really apprehensive, but pimp.
Don't worry, you'll get laid tonight.
I just want him to be a pimp, really, though.
We got pimps all around, right? Pimps in the house.
I'm going to go with pot, just for the hell of it. Right,
against the grain.
I got fucked over on the first diamond, so this one's pot.
I'm going to have to say pot.
Diamond Bradley is a pimp.
Yes!
Swinging. His quote... Purse first, ass last.
Motherfucker.
That's the quote of the day right there.
I'm sorry, repeat that?
What? Say that one more time.
Yeah. Purse.
Coin purse?
Purse first, ass last.
Hashbag.
That's like a life motto right that's, there.
That's what I'm more used to. That's
a man you guys shut up and hand me another beer.
That's a man that's got his mind on his money.
And his money. Oh, my
absolutely.
God.
Really? He should write a song. All right, we're going to take it back to Alex and go the other way.
Okay.
Alex, your name. Maestro Tickle.
Sex move.
That sounds like it's from Urban Dictionary. the Maestro Tickle, huh? I think that involves a teacher, but I'm going to have to go with pot.
To Jenny.
I'm going to say pot.
Daddy.
That's a fancy man. A pimp.
That's a fancy man.
He tickles the ivory and he tickles his bitches. He's getting paid the whole time.
Maestro Tickle, Cotty, pot or pimp?
I say pot.
I'm going to say pot. Pimp, but I'm wrong.
And lastly,
I'm going to say pot.
Maestro Tickle is indeed a pimp.
You were wrong that you're wrong.
Right.
Clearly.
Here's what Maestro Tickle has to say. Pimps do what they want to do. Hoes do what they told. And a square does what he can.
That's some deep advice.
Yeah, this shit's deep, man. Yeah.
Well,
I guess
shit.
I do what I can. Yeah.
We should bring him on the podcast.
We should. That guy's...
We need to get Maestro Tickle on the podcast.
Maestro Tickle, please.
Look him up on Twitter.
We'll have to find him.
Yeah, I'm sure he's on Twitter.
Dowdy, I'm going to take this one down to you. Chic love. Pot or pimp?
No, that's pot.
Take it to Cotty.
Pot.
I'm going to say pimp.
Powders.
What was it again?
Chic love.
Oh, you high.
Oh, that's a pimp.
Actually, that's not pot. I think that's weed.
I've smoked that.
That's got to be weed.
It's not a pot. You want to get high? I'm going to say that's pot.
And Jenny.
I think it's a pimp.
We got a nice mix. I like this.
Love.
Chic love is a pimp.
Pimp, yeah. For sure.
Wow.
Love. Man, I'm wrong.
Chic love has also been graceful enough. He has a word of caution about hoes. Are you guys, want to listen?
I know all about them.
Sure. They're trifling.
It's not wise for aspiring playas and divas to keep street hoes or closet hoes in their stable. Hoes can ruin.
In their stable?
Oh, yes.
In their stable.
Hoes can ruin a player's reputation and bank accounts. They are distractions because they can't be trusted. Don't let them sway your focus with their trifling ways. They are parasites. They are cheaters and player haters who try to mooch and steal from true hardworking dons and divas who are living the good life.
The wisest man I've ever heard.
That's a little too much. You lost me.
This is an important time.
He pimps them out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know, but he doesn't pimp hoes.
Not hoes.
He pimps honest hoes.
What's a monologuing pimp?
Closet hoes. What's a closet
hose? Respectable hoes?
I mean, a closet hoe is like a... She.
Where does the chart go? Where do you go?
She says she ain't a hoe, but she's wearing a hoe's uniform.
Next segment, where the chart lies?
Okay. Hoe to escort. Where's the line?
Did a governor pick you up? No, you're a hoe.
Mm. I think that's the line.
That's getting cut up, by the way. You know that's coming back.
We got two more for the tiebreaker since that doesn't make sense and we're not keeping score.
Points don't matter.
The points don't matter. Ken.
Yeah.
Oak Town Crippler. Potter Pimp.
His dad.
I believe that is the Chicago dog.
That's true. I always see the hoe train walking out all limp.
It is crippling them.
Towing their vagina on a stretcher.
It's like he hands out rickets every night.
It's going to take me hours to ravel his shit back up.
Oh, shit.
Got to put that shit away.
I'm going to say pot.
I got it caught in the door again.
I'm going to say pot.
All right.
I want to hear you say it again.
Oak Town Crippler.
That's what she said.
That could be a pot.
That's definitely a pot.
Jose.
I'm going to say pot.
Oh, my God.
Ken, can you get off the table?
What?
I mean, Ken, get off
the
table. Keith, get off the table.
Keith, listen up.
We're going to move the mic away from your mouth. I'm going to go with pot. The Oak Town Crippler is pot. Definitely pot.
Running the pot train.
Mm-hmm. Kind of think it's pot.
I want it to be a pimp.
Doesn't make it true.
That's a serious pimp right there.
That's a serious goddamn
He's
pimp.
Not fucking around.
That
there
is
no,
a confident man.
That's not love.
That's not a
cripple you.
That's not a pimp, though. That's more like a serial murderer.
That's a guy's like, bitch, you fucking work. You clock on. You get my money. And you clock off, and there ain't no benefits.
Or you get crippled.
No, you know what that name is? That's a name somebody else gave him. Like, enough people were like, yeah, that guy's
reputation, even better.
Yeah. That guy's a whole man.
It better be a pimp.
You now we have his whole backstory.
I made it up. Let's do this.
He looks like Dolomite.
Please be true. Please be true.
Cotty. Oaktown Crippler.
I'll go with pimp because that was just too awesome.
It is pretty awesome, but it is, of course, pot.
Fuck!
Yeah! Damn it.
Of course.
And you couldn't have said that louder into the microphone.
An interesting review. A mellow high that goes a long way, aiding in pain relief and social hangups.
Mellow high?
Yeah.
Social hangups. Perfect for Kenneth.
All right, this one.
Can I vote that we just changed the answer and it was what I said?
No.
That was pretty good.
No.
All right, last one.
I've decided that that's going to be.
This is the tiebreaker. Whoever gets this one wins the game.
That's right. Even if y'all get it.
What the fuck?
Powder.
Okay.
Pot or pimp. Iceberg slicky.
That's a pimp.
That's a bad night.
Yeah, I do not want to put iceberg slicky in my mouth.
Kenneth, down to you.
I would say pot.
Cotty.
I don't know.
You got to pick one.
Can you say it again?
Iceberg slicky.
I'll go with pot.
Take it down, Daddy.
By the way, that's going to get cut up, too. I wanted to be a pimp.
That's a pimp.
It's
sure.
Not a guess anymore. This is just all hope.
This is what he's hoping for.
Hopes
These
and
are
dreams.
His life dreams.
Jenny.
I'm going to say pimp whose favorite movie is the Titanic.
Oh, that's specific.
No,
that's, wow. That's depressing for a pimp.
He's never going to let go. Is that what you're hoping?
That's oddly specific.
Bitch, you ain't leaving.
Cool as ice.
Cold-blooded.
I'm going to go with pot. I'm going to go with pot.
And Jose.
I'm going to go with pot again.
Iceberg Slicky is pimp.
Pimp! Yeah. Pimp, pimp, yes. Pimp!
Is he white?
I Big win!
Big pimp, Iceberg Slicky. Mr. Slicky credits his mother for having prepared him for the pimp lifestyle by pampering during his childhood. Take note, pampered sons, because you, like Iceberg Slicky, could spend nearly a quarter century as a full-time Chicago pimp.
A quarter century?
I told you. I knew Iceberg Slicky where I was from. That's how I won this game.
Did he try to pimp your Chicago dog?
No comment.
Congratulations, Cotty. You won. Yay.
Cotty, because you've won, now your moment.
No.
Don't fuck it up.
Who do you want to thank?
No. You have a moment.
Say
Cotty.
Thanks.
You got music
words,
and everything.
Tell us who you appreciate right now. Was it Jesus?
I appreciate Kevin over there because that was ridiculous.
Ridiculous?
And everyone here got it wrong at least once.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
That's good.
That's cool. That's
I wish I got
life.
It right way more times than I actually did.
That's why you're dating Chris Dowdy.
Shut up.
That was cute.
There's no room for that shit here.
Yeah, there is.
You got
yeah,
and there. I really love Jenny's hair.
Thank you.
I love it. I keep staring
Let's
at it.
Let's all bring it back to me again.
Yes.
She's got plenty of room for an award. Sorry.
This song's got like another 15 seconds. You
Yeah, Cotty yielded her time.
Yeah.
I'll donate some of my time to Jenny.
Oh, there you go.
I feel like my time should be...
And that's it. So,
bitch!
We're gonna take a break real fast. It's Dirty Daddy Podcast, Longbox.fm. It's brought to you tonight by Riley's Brewing.
Thanks, Riley's.
New beer coming out this Friday night at Das Bierhaus, 5 o'clock Friday night. It's the Warthog IPA. And Kenneth... You finally get allowed to talk. It's funny because you talk all the time without being allowed, but you get a chance with the Tardies. It's coming up here next on Longbox.fm.
Listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm.
Rocking across the Central Valley, through cities, and out to the world, this is Longbox.FM.
I will go ahead and say this right now.
Say it.
If Helmet ever comes on and they are guests here in the studio, that will be the last Dirty Dowdy podcast. That will be it. I will have hit my climax.
It will have to be the literal, like, end.
And it, I want them to perform that song.
At the very end.
And that would be it. I'd be done.
That kind of makes me worried because when people say shit like that, it usually happens.
Yeah.
Then I want that. Also, the same show, I'm going to have Bree Olsen come in and fuck me live on camera, too.
Can we have Clover, too? Because I kind of want
Clover. No, this isn't about you right now, Kenneth. It's about to be about
you.
Get
your own show.
So we had an interesting, fun show. We went classy with the Art Hop, the Cake Art Hop. By the way, check them out at cakeworldwide.com. And tomorrow night, Thursday, you can see Jason and his tender whore as they hang out. And
we don't know that she's a whore yet.
Yeah, we do.
She's on Tinder. We're no, pretty close.
I mean,
if she's going out with Jason.
I really, right? really hope she's not listening.
really, really hope she's a whore.
Yeah, this would be.
I didn't say that.
This would be like a major cock
it's
block.
Pretty close, Jason.
Either way, we do know she'll be a fucking Chuck, and we'll talk about it next week at
a
the opening
Chuck.
Show.
You're fucking Chuck?
Is that that's what we learned this week?
Hooray.
Yeah, what we learned this week next week. So, Jason, hit that. I'll record it, maybe. We'll get some audio.
And it'll be Jason's segment.
So, anyways,
it's more than
it's
a segment.
The Cake Art Hop coming up tomorrow night, Thursday night. It's at 1570 North Wishon Avenue. Start there. You can walk around with a box of wine. We may go out there. I think Cottie is already signed up for that.
I think she's already there.
She just went, huh? What?
I'm always there.
Mm-hmm. Like a deer in the headlights. And now, the moment we've all not waited for.
Yeah.
The Tardies with Kenneth. Hit the sound.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We have the best does of the night with the Tardies with me. Yeah, DJ voice, whatever.
That was a D. Oh, okay. I had no idea.
That sounds like a dick in your mouth.
It's not a gravity competition anytime soon. So. We have the first award of the night, which is hashtag of the day, and there were a lot of fucking hashtags to choose from. We had hashtags such as smart bitches love honesty and shut the hell up, Alex, but those one of those was mine, so I can't choose that. But we have the number one hashtag of the day, which everybody here seemed to love, and it was difficult to choose this, but I gotta say, Flock of Dicks was number one. Everybody loves a flock of dicks.
Flock of Dicks is good.
I gotta admit, though, number two was herpes and pancakes, and I do love pancakes.
Herpes and pancakes, what can go wrong?
So, I do love pancakes.
We do have my favorite segment, which everybody's been catching on to the last couple of weeks, and it is the best boobs of the show. I gotta admit, there was some slight competition tonight between
was
two
Kevin,
of the
was
members.
Was Kevin a runner-up?
Yes, Kevin was runner-up for...
Both
three.
Of them.
So it was a tie for a moment, but I gotta admit, number two segment winner was Best Boobs winner was Jenny.
Always.
Oh, said Colin.
We don't have a best periscope because nobody was throwing their tits into the periscope app this time.
The Periscope app
you
is
were.
Not in my tits. Let's get this straight.
Because
I'm throwing them everywhere.
The Periscope app failed.
Because Dowdy was a pussy, I gotta admit.
Actually, we got more hearts on your tits than anything else.
Yeah.
Ooh.
You got
then
fans,
I gotta like... be happy and thrilled and sad at the same time.
And you will
we have
you
a new
cry Jack later.
That's
shut
what
the fuck up, Dowdy, before
hashtag,
you gotta...
Hashtag Kenneth Cryjacks.
Yeah.
You're Jack. The one that made them dance.
Oscar of the day also goes to Dowdy. But anyway.
Tear jerk.
Third award. Fuck you, Griffin. Third award is Pest Pickup Line, and it goes to Powder. And it is... Who wants to hear this, actually? because I don't give a shit.
Say it. just say it.
It is, yeah. Did you fall from heaven? Because, well, fuck, have sex with me. And as from Powder, thank you, Powder.
I don't think you quite got the lesson from today.
I think you should repeat that line.
No. I think Powder should repeat it.
Did you?
You see, you give him a little bit of power, and he becomes a dick.
Quite you.
A very small one.
Sad.
The next award
one.
Comes to the worst interviewer for the segment Kevin Asks, which is handed off to, I guess, Alex. And worst interviewer comes to Alex. I'm sorry, Alex. That was shit.
No, I had a wonderful time. So
it was awesome. It was awesome, but it was terrible at the same time.
Wait a minute.
Time.
That's the point. If he was bad at it, is it really Kevin's questions that made Alex's interview bad?
Yeah,
I'm
probably.
Not sure.
That's why I said worst interviewer.
That was a nice guy.
I said worst interviewer. So
I don't think it was that. I think it was just the fear that his daughter was in the room.
See, I noticed that there was somebody here that usually isn't there.
A young one. Yeah, I know. She's
yeah.
So,
I think, yeah, I think
let's be honest, she might have been worst interviewer, but no, it was Alex. Yeah.
So without saying it, I kind of used Alex as a human shield.
Good job, Kevin.
But
that's kind of
I
couldn't think
obvious.
Of a funny way to say that, so I'm not going
that's
to.
That's kind of like a Megan's Law-ish type of thought process.
No, Amber Alert. We were going hardcore on that.
Why don't you take a seat right over there?
Amber Alert stealing a kid. Red Square is raping one.
This is at Chris Hansen.
What's more hardcore?
#HumanShield to Kevin.
I'll take it.
I don't think it's good to end on an underage rape.
We do have I want to be on, here
anymore.
We
do have a show MVP, and I believe it does go to O.J. Simpson.
All right.
Because
that's me!
That's me!
Because Dowdy has been asking for it for fucking weeks. And on top of that, Jenny, could you tell the joke of today? Because I can't remember it at the moment.
Oh, my God. Okay, so Jason handed off the Tinder to Dowdy, and he asked, I'm going to buy you a drink. And she said, what are you going to buy me? And he said, I'm going to buy you a Nicole Brown. What's in it? OJ.
It's brilliant. I don't know why she didn't fuck you.
So great.
I'm really disappointed.
You know why?
Too.
Because Jenny didn't say it to her. That's
and ladies and
it would have been way sexier.
It was
if
text.
I
yeah. You
that
can't do that in text.
Yes, yeah, I can.
Good. And ladies and
well,
gentlemen,
you
know
my powers.
You are not Jenny.
Shut the fuck up.
I'll let you type for me next time,
ladies
Jenny.
And gentlemen, thank Hell you. Yeah. This is the Tardies, and Dowdy has been getting his wish. O.J. Simpson's finally made the Tardies from prison. Thank you.
Does that make me the winner?
Yeah. Sure.
No, it doesn't.
And I'm going to go with a theme tonight. Jenny, let me hear it. You
yes,
got some
Dan.
Time.
Now I have time? Oh, that's fantastic, because I have so much to say.
And we're done.
Oh, I thought you were going
to
cut
right,
me
so
right
next
there.
Week, tune in as Jenny learns how to use words.
I only have till next week.
I mean, I got this one. I got this one to my side, cutting me off like the fucking Oscars. That's bullshit.
Because
my show.
You deserved it.
And I got this one who begs for airtime and then doesn't use it.
I don't beg for shit.
I've got the box wine bitch. I've got they can't get any bitch. The two big dick bitch.
I'm waiting to see what you come up with.
The Potter pimp bitch.
Oh, here we go.
Okay. But yeah, Jose doesn't know when to talk, bitch. And now it's the worst interview of ever, but also the most awesome guy who also grabs my dick at any opportunity possible in a professional work environment.
Yeah, and in
here.
A professional way.
That is true. He caresses nicely.
He always cups the balls.
We've got so many bitches on the show.
Anyway, as a reminder, this Friday at Das Bierhaus, Riley's Brewing and Warthog's collaboration IPA release. There's less than 1,000 bottles. It's pretty cool. They got some really good stuff.
Do you
619
think they,
East Olive Avenue.
They like following dick jokes?
They do like following dick jokes. Actually, I know the guys pretty well. They make a lot of dick jokes and drink beer. But yes, that's Friday at Das Bierhaus. Dowdy, it's all you.
Well, that's it. This show, thank you guys for listening. It's been 4 weeks back after a long, long break. I'll get porn on the show soon.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
You should do #porn.
And hashtag DDP podcast porn. Actually, DDP.
Wait. We discussed this earlier.
Now we need a spelling tournament.
DDP is redundant. It's like saying ATM machine or PIN number. Did you know that?
Yes. I agree with that. I had two questions.
Jason, buy a real bed, not the inflatable mattress.
What does that have to do with anything?
Deflate. It's the Dirty Daddy Podcast here on Longbox.fm, and I'm saying word.
Word.
You've been listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm. The opinions expressed on the Dirty Dowdy Podcast aren't necessarily those of staff, management, or sponsors. The Dirty Dowdy Podcast is a presentation of Longbox.fm.